Hey, what's up everyone? Gerard here with today's daily shave video, and today we're going to be shaving with Colonel Conk's bay rum. And so this is a classic soap from Colonel Conk. I believe at the time of this recording, this may be dollar for dollar the cheapest soap price-wise on West Coast shaving. So I'm going to be actually talking about this, answering some of those questions and things like that. And I have it loaded here on what may be the most inexpensive brush on West Coast shaving. This is the Omega 10049. This is a boar hair brush. Talk a little bit about some boar. This is a nice red handle here. And kind of going with that. Shaving-wise, classic West Coast shaving 78S. I have a rapier blade in here on its first use, and that's kind of it. That's kind of what I'm planning for now. We'll talk a little bit about, some other stuff about the shave, but let's go for it, okay? So, the time of recording, it's evening where I'm at right now, so I did shower this morning, but gonna go for it just with a little bit of water. Okay, preloaded this. I typically have done the whole 50 swirl lather, but because this is a bit small, and just to kind of show in comparison, I have here a tub of the Soloist from West Coast Shaving. This is a nice 5 ounce tub, and you can see just how small it is. So what I did is I loaded straight off the little container here, but I did 100 swirls, okay? So 100 swirls with the boar brush. I'll kind of just see how this goes. This is more of an experiment for me, okay? Now, Colonel Conk has been out there for quite some time, maybe for a dollar, for probably, I think the 2 ounce version when I bought it was about $3.25. Okay? And for that price, it might be the best deal if you just need a soap in kind of a hurry. Okay? So I've kind of put some stuff here. This is an avocado oil and glycerin based soap. Okay? And as you can see, we're kind of just like painting it on here. Not really developing the lather, just kind of getting the soap bit on my face. Now, this brush here, this is a boar brush that I've broken in. Okay. And then we're kind of at that point where I've painted on pretty nicely, but I haven't really developed the lather. So I'm just going to dip the tips in here, just did it right now, and kind of just see what we're going to get, with it, okay? Now, this avocado oil glycerin-based soap, I'll tell you off the bat, it's not the slickest soap I've used. It's probably on the lower end of the spectrum as far as that's concerned. But I think when you add enough water and kind of work at it, you can definitely get something that's usable. Okay. So, as I kind of splay this, you can see I'm getting a workable lather, but I think I can still go for it. Because I do think it can take an exceptional amount of water, but it tends to break off somewhat easily. So you can see in there, It's getting there, right? And I'm just gonna see if this will get pretty much everywhere. So definitely took a little bit of time, but I think pretty good. Pretty good lather. Okay. So here we go. Let's go shaving 78S. Now, Colonel Conk. Bay rum, as you can imagine, smells like bay rum. Very, very almost medicinal. Bay rum is one of a classic scents out there. Seems like everyone early on may try to put a bay rum scent out there. Not the biggest fan of it. Some people think it's leans like on the oriental end of the fragrance spectrum. You see it in a lot of what it would be classified as an oriental scent, and I could agree with that. Okay. As far as performance goes, yeah, it as a soap, it's doing its job. It's providing just the minimum amount of slickness necessary, I think, for the razor to glide. But is it a slick soap? No, I would definitely say not. How's the residual slickness? I'll probably tell you on this pass. Okay. I do have a kind of a good amount of lather still in of soap here in the handle. But as you can see, I don't know if it picks up. It's just, it is picking up rather light. And then you can see some of the bubbles. So even as I kind of put it on here, it's not, can't say it's the best performing soap as far as that's concerned. Yeah, like residual slickness, minimal at best. It just feels like moist skin. Maybe after like you've taken like a shower or wash your face. It doesn't really lend itself to kind of doing its thing, you know. Okay. All right. The scent, as you can see, like here on the chin, it's kind of dissipated already. Now, for my third pass, I'm actually going to kind of, not necessarily rehydrate, but what I did is when I was loading the brush, any excess I kind of put here into my little bowl. So what I'm going to do is kind of develop, to just to show you that it can develop into something, you know, quite plentiful. So there's a little bit of proto-lather in there. I still have what's in here in the bowl. I haven't gone back to the puck. And as I kind of go in here, okay, I'll mention that this bowl is from Sterling and carry a lot of their stuff, but this bowl, and I think any bowl with significant nubs or little agitators, if you will, it can really like develop the lather quite nicely. and quite quickly, okay? So even with that in there, as you're about to see, you know, I can just do a little bit of water just to kind of get it in there. I can get a decent last load, okay? So I typically tend to be a face lather, and as you can see, look, it's pretty thick. I mean, peaky, nice, okay? I can work on that in there, and there are many bowls on West Coast Shaving. I think the Timeless one is nice on there. Definitely, you can develop the lather quite nicely there. I just don't have it. But when you have a soap that doesn't necessarily lather like you want it to on your face, put some in a bowl. And even if you just have a regular small bowl, use it to load. Use it to kind of go in there, splay out the hairs and you know, the fibers, like in a brush, okay? And see what you can do. Because not going back, getting a wonderful, wonderful lather like on here. And I'm just gonna go see what I can get most of it. Because this is my last pass anyway. And look at that, right? So, wow. Yeah, great lather. Probably the method I would go with when you just don't have something that kind of whips up correctly. Using a shave bowl with specific agitators or grooves or anything like that, dimples. It can be really, really easy to just get the lather that you want to get, like nice, light, yet voluminous. And, you know, here you go, all right? So last pass. Slightly better. What I would probably tell you to do, if you're going to get something like Colonel Conk, because it is a perfectly acceptable performing soap. I do think that we tend to be a little bit spoiled with our options, because there are so many good soap bases out there. But some of us, you know, just don't have the means to go for the latest and greatest. Some people will be like, no, I'm perfectly happy using something a little bit more within my budget. Okay? Yeah, my face, it doesn't feel great. Okay? Feels clean. But I definitely imagine it drying out relatively quickly, okay? I don't have a matching aftershave for it. Here on the side, I do have, there's some Thayer's Witch Hazel. This is not, just to be clear, this is an astringent. It's meant to, you know, really like clean your face and without the burn of alcohol. Unscented works perfectly fine, but right now, I can tell you in about probably 15-20 minutes, my face is going to feel rather dry. Okay, so I'm going to use just a dab Sudsy Soapery Unscented Balm. You know, That's it. I'm just going to kind of rub it in my skin. And that's it. Now, my face feels pretty nice. It does feel hydrated. Shave pretty good. Not a BBS shave, but thumbs up on it, okay? I've definitely had worse shaves with like super inferior products. But that was it. I hope you enjoyed the video. I know it's something a little bit different than what some of us may be used to and everything, but you know, sometimes, you know, we just kind of like go searching, like, you know, maybe we're a first timer or not, we don't really know what we're getting ourselves into. You might run into Colonel Conk and you might pick it up and just be like, hey, is this good? Is this, you know, decent at the very least? And if you've been using the stuff in a can or the gels or anything and like that, a lot of that stuff, it has, you know, a bunch of chemicals that's really not good for your skin, and it's just, you know, you're kind of overpaying for it. So if you want to spend just like $3, you can pick this up. You can pick up an Omega 10049, you know, boar brush here, and you can get a halfway decent shave with it. And in the end, I think that's what we're all just looking for. You know, just not to only enjoy ourselves, but ultimately just to have good performance and a good shave. But that was it. Hope you enjoyed watching. If you have any questions, any comments at all, you know, am I an idiot for doing any of this? Or, you know, are you a person that maybe Conk was your first foray into wet shaving and you still have a little bit of a soft spot for it? You know, check it out. Leave a comment down below. I'll be always in there. And we'll see you in the next one. Peace.